Anna, could you clean this place?
Would you stop blaming everyone else but yourself?
Now? Are we, Hannah? Jack?
You're Daniel, such...
Are we recording now?
Yes.
Thank you. And say, yes, chef.
Yes. Heard. Heard.
Are we cooking something?
Yeah, yes, chef. This is real life, guys. You know, this is adversity. This is where we...
That's how we're
thrive, I think. Yeah.
Let me have a look at Lindsay there. Lindsay, you look great. You look absolutely great.
Fab, thanks. Are you zooming straight into my tits, it feels
like? Yeah. Well,
great.
Then, listen, I'm a doctor.
Get them out.
Okay, let's have a look.
I purposely covered up.
Let's have a look. So, she'd need to be there.
Let me make sure that...
Give us a look at Lindsay's shop, Jack Daniel. Give us a look. Give us a look at Hannah's shot. Give us a look at my shot. Okay, am I okay, guys?
Is there a Yelshin Hal?
No. I do have one for a but it's shite.
Yeah.
My ex got it for me, but like it's so tiny I can barely fit my phone in it. So I got this one on DHgate, €60.
Yeah.
Real leather.
How am I doing, Daniel? How
very
how
good
do I
copy.
Look?
And I pretend, like, if I'm out, I kind of
what's
hold
that, Jack?
It like...
I can't say that again, Jack.
I went into Brian Thomas the other
I can't
day. They were
hear
like,
Jack, what are you saying?
Oh my God, your Chanel.
What
are
you
saying?
Yeah, it's good.
I was just
really?
Saying,
they didn't
you,
know.
It
no.
I've
yeah.
gone into Chanel and looked at the real ones of these.
Yeah, yeah.
No, it's good.
Same.
It's good.
You
it's
have to give me
sharp.
The website.
I
you
will.
Okay,
like
shut the F up. Right.
I'm talking about handbags.
Wow.
Real Chanel.
Yes, my
real
okay.
Chanel.
Do you want to just
wide.
Set yourself up and put your headphones on, my dear?
Yeah.
You look amazing, Lindsay. Oh
my
God.
Jesus,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you so much.
Okay, Hannah.
You never give me that many compliments.
Well,
because
you don't look as, you know, I'm sorry. I don't want to hurt your feelings. You don't look
Hannah's
that great.
A stunner.
Hannah's a stunner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know that. Everyone watching knows that.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, Jack,
okay.
Daniel, let's go. Jesus, Hannah.
Yes. What's going on?
Hannah has the patience of a saint.
Okay,
do you get that all the time?
Let's go, Daniel.
I think we're going. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to... And That's Why We're Not Together, starring David McSavage and Hannah Andrews, with special guest Lindsay
Hamilton.
Thank
you. I have many different online names.
Thank you. And I'd like to also welcome my two princes, Jack and Daniel. Someday this kingdom will
be yours.
Well done. Lindsay, it's so great to see you. My
great
God, I can't
you.
Believe you're here. I'm looking at you and I can't believe it's you. Is it you?
I think so.
Yeah, you look great.
Yeah, so do you. You're obsessed with that vape.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because you know what I mean? We both have
I know. You're highly obsessed to the
we
vape.
We both
I'm only semi-obsessed. You're fully in the
throes. Don't hit the microphone. Hey, we
it's going to happen.
But you know what? I think this is like your suitor. You know?
Yes.
You never grew up of this. So
yeah, yeah, yeah,
first
yeah.
you have the pseudo, then you have a vape.
You have dimples.
I do. Yeah.
I have as well.
Oh, no, yes.
Yeah, but you do when if they go like that. They don't like naturally go no. like when Lindsay does it.
You're rude. You're rude.
No, I mean,
just like
everybody
children.
Has a dimple if you're like this. Like,
no, I can see Hannah's dimple right now.
But I'm just saying, when Lindsay smiles, it's immediately endearing. Whether she,
yes.
whether
yes.
that the she deserves it or not, whether you could be endearing, but it doesn't because
yes.
dimples trick
it's,
people.
It's hidden.
Do you know what dimples are called in Denmark, guys?
No.
Smile holes.
Yeah, in Danish.
Smilehuller.
Smilehuller.
Yeah.
Because they are smile holes.
Okay. So that's fascinating. So look, Lindsay
mm-hmm.
Hamilton, my goodness. You first came on my radar. You first came on my radar because
yes.
I have a little radar. No, I think there was some girls who live up the road and they were talking about It Gals, your
yeah.
podcast, which kind of got really successful relatively quickly or not.
I think so. I'm not good with time or numbers.
Or numbers.
But I think, yeah.
But it seemed like it was going to go from strength to strength to strength to strength.
Except that we hated each other, so it just...
Did you always have a... was there always a frisson, a tension between you and your co-host?
What does that mean? Frisson?
Was there always tension between you and your co... I've forgotten your co-host's name.
Jenny.
Why are you laughing? Because you don't even want to say her name.
I do get a bit scared to say her name because she sued me. Because I signed something that was like, I will never say her name again.
You signed something.
Yeah, but
we'll
then,
just call it.
But then I did it. But no, the suing's over.
Yeah, yeah.
I won.
Oh right. Oh, you.
So it's fine. So
but
now
you
I can actually
say
that.
It.
That letter was, it's yeah. just, it, or that thing I signed was because I was, I signed under duress. That's how I won the suing thing. So.
Well, yeah, but the.
That's a legal term I learned. Apparently it just means I was quite pushed into signing
but so it ended in, with a legal battle.
Yes, I know. So dramatic.
And what was the nature of the.
I've never told the whole story. Because it involves like my ex, it was just I've just never said the story.
Yeah, the story of the actual
what actually happened. Yeah, because it's a bit like
because it involves people who don't want to be.
I don't really want to get into this. Like we were friends for 10 years. I don't want to get into this back and forth battle. She'll have pictures of me doing God knows what and saying God.
Oh,
knows
and she has her. She has her. Timeline of events and you
yes.
have yours and they might differ.
Yeah. So yeah. I just am like
just leave it.
It was going to die at some point. It was never meant to be forever.
And how long did you do the podcast for?
I think like 3 years.
Were you surprised by how successful it got?
No.
Because or did you know going why are you laughing at that, Jack? Because it's a stupid
it's
question.
No, it's
you is mean, it, is it, did I just say did you think did you huh? What did I just?
No, you're good. It's a bit of an interrogation, but I like it. You know, it's, we're getting the answers.
Yeah, I wasn't surprised. Why?
Yeah. So did you go?
Why was I not surprised?
Well, no. In other words, did you go in with a plan? Like you say, you weren't surprised. So you must have had an expectation that it was going to do well.
I started on Snapchat. I was single, 2 kids, and I was just like, Snapchat was a big platform. That was the platform at the time,
yeah.
And you would just like. Put up random videos. I don't even know what I put up. Like it's still actually on the app. It saves it all in an archive. So I was just putting up whatever, doing skits, and then that got a lot of viewers quite quickly. And
yeah,
then,
you were doing. I think that's possibly where I might have seen you as well.
Maybe.
Where you were doing rants. I don't know, but just but really honest.
Yeah, I guess
saying,
that's
saying really honest stuff, which I found quite refreshing. Well, very refreshing because
I think
a lot
that wasn't the case back then. A lot of it was like Suzanne Jackson, Rosie Connolly, very preened, pristine people.
Well, it's still not the case. I think still people are quite safe and guarded and aren't really that honest.
Well, people are afraid of themselves.
Or they're afraid of what might happen if they open up.
And nothing happens. Like people always say to me, you know, why are you so like you're just not private. I protect my privacy. I'm a private person. I'm like, I could find out everything about you and who your fella's fucking in 2 minutes. Ireland, you have no secrets. I know everything about everyone.
That's true.
Lindsay
I think
could
in
find
Ireland
out
you can't cheat.
Lindsay could find out who you are and who your fella's fucking. That's like, I found out who you are and who your fella's fucking.
Yeah.
Oh, Mickey. Hey, Mickey, I'm so fine. You don't understand. Like, I'm a fan, your
yeah.
fella fucking.
But you know, that annoys me when people say that. Like,
yeah.
You're
but you know,
out your
I was really impressed because I've never listened to it. Before.
Well, you're not
yeah.
exactly her
and
demographic.
Yeah,
you're old.
You know, I didn't know that existed. And then I listened to it. And I think it was before William Vogue and Joanna McCarley podcast,
yes.
who are just like continuation of your podcast.
In
almost.
A way.
Yeah.
I don't listen to them.
No, I haven't listened because it's, I haven't listened continuously, but like I listened to one or two and to yours and they... You know, they've taken from you that sort of format.
I think in a way, but I think that's always existed. Like we had The Simple Life with Nicole Richie and Paris Hilton. Like twosomes, girls in twosomes will always be kind of interesting, I think.
But there is this kind of, it's almost like this big sleeping group of people that aren't being catered to or represented or something. And I think that's why you got successful. And then Joanne... She achieved kind of superstardom.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, she put the work in, you know, but...
yes.
You know, she's a hard worker, Joanne.
Oh, she's a great worker. Great
she,
worker.
She was very... She was... when I knew Joanne early on, like, she was frighteningly ambitious, which is...
Mm.
Which is I've never suffered from that curse. but she was like you would almost sometimes in company like she would you felt like you were looking it was like a black panther she was just like you know, and just and calculating stuff. But she was good. I'll tell you why she was good. Because I'd get into, I'd hang out in comedy clubs and get involved in all the bullshit and the machinations and all the fucking cliques and shit and gossip. But Joanne tended, Joanne just went in, did a gig and fucked off.
To another gig.
Well, or to another gig.
She was working really hard, but maybe because maybe not she was to another gig,
actually.
Well.
That's a dig at me, by the way.
But I remember her.
And by the way, and also,
that's
also
what she was doing.
I was admiring Peter Talon's fucking hair. And then, oh, I'm gay all of a sudden. Can a man, not a heterosexual man, not, you know, appreciate someone else's hair without being gay?
Yes,
you're so homophobic.
But why are you so angry?
But you're so
I'm angry because I'm
why
angry.
Why are you so angry?
Because
you
I'm a man.
Embrace it.
You're fanny-phobic. Huh? Because when poor Hannah was talking about Caniston and Thrush, I saw on the podcast and you were like, like, don't, as have you had Thrush before? Because men can get it. And I know I've given to it. A fair few men.
You've given Thrush to a fair few
I
men.
I have. The cock completely withers and loses about 2 inches.
We refer to the
Did
cock
you do it on purpose? Or
I needed an inner itch. That's all I can say.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Van Man.
Caniston doesn't really work for me. I need to get the prescribed Caniston. That shit hits diff.
Oh, really strong one.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I love Caniston. It's great. We should
are
be
you,
sponsored
are you
by Caniston.
Use natural yogurt?
I have. I've put like a tampon into a natural yogurt and just shoved it. Oh, this is stunning. It's really nice. That I don't use tampons usually. But
and then if you forgot it was up there, it would turn into cheese.
Well, no, you die if you leave a tampon or you lose a leg.
Yeah,
that's
why
I don't use them.
You lose a leg if you forget to
there
a tampon on
there.
Yeah,
like
there's a model who lost a leg. She has a bionic leg. And that would be me because I'm quite forgetful.
So we're just saying, so you're telling me I'm afraid of the vagina and you're just explaining it's a hostile, acidic environment.
If
no wonder
well,
I'm
it's
fucking
a bleached
afraid.
Cotton thing
you know,
that
I
you're
mean,
putting up there.
Right, so, you know, I think is actual fear of vagina called vagina dentata or something? Or believing that vaginas have teeth or something?
There's you some just like, you pretend to be a prude for some reason when I've been in your company. And
I do not pretend.
To, you do, you're like, oh my God, whenever I say like something semi-sexual.
Yes. Semi-sexual.
Yeah.
Semi-sexual, semi-successful.
And so why do you want to portray yourself as a gay man sometimes?
Are you bi? I think
no,
we're all
no,
bi.
No, I think if you're gay, you'll know about it. You know what I mean? Like, it's not something I'm I'd never look at a man and think, yeah, I'd really like to be with a man.
Yeah, but have you looked at a vagina and been like, I really want that? Not really. Like, I'm not exactly looking at dicks being like, that is what, that's me.
Yeah, but it's really what the vagina is, who the vagina is attached to.
I think it's
society. It's part of...
That's what I'm saying, bro. It's society. If
so
we all grew up in like...
But I mean, in other words, if your car, if you just look at the exhaust pipe, I mean, what do you know about it? You know, you have to, you know, the vagina...
Are you suggesting that? Like, because there are some men who do fuck exhaust pipes.
No, I think they put plastic vaginas on cars and fuck the cars.
They use Hoovers.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, it's vacuum cleaners.
Oh, they put the flash or the fleshlight in the exhaust.
And they rev it up the car.
There was a movie on that where people fall in love with objects. Like the Eiffel
Tower.
Oh, yeah,
well, I think I'm definitely in that camp.
So you love that? Is what
no,
you're
no, I don't love that. There are certain things.
Does that go anywhere like other than the mouth?
There's certain things that. Well, you see, that's who was I talking to? I was talking to somebody who works in A&E. Why are you checking your watch? Rude.
It's not a watch. It's a little bangle that was just kind of getting caught around my little.
So people
bump.
Who work. So I was talking to somebody who works in A&E, and they're saying, "Oh, this guy comes in with stuff up their arse. You know, they jam stuff up their ass." And then you'd be thinking, Jesus, would you, you know, what
is that what this is for?
What are you at? No, but I
what's
I think,
with the crystal?
Well, I think a lot of my madness and a lot of, you know, all the stuff that builds up pressure comes out. I have that outlet as a performer on stage. But I think regular folk, all the shit that they have to deal with during the day, so they have to have some outlet. And some people, it skews towards... God knows what, fucking sticking things up their arse and spitting on each other and fucking eating shite
terrible
and all that.
Terrible goings on.
What?
Terrible goings on.
Terrible goings on.
Yeah. People do stuff with gerbils as well.
Oh, yeah.
No, that's
I've
not
heard
true,
about
though. I'm sure that's
well.
An urban myth. So people.
I don't think so.
People.
I don't know anyone who.
People apparently shave gerbils.
Oh, they shave them?
And then they put a tube up their arse, and then they get the gerbils to crawl up their arse and move around.
Oh, yeah.
It's funny, I was doing, can I just quickly tell a story? I was doing a gig in Moscow for Johnny O'Reilly, and I was performing in front of Moscovites, and they all had their headphones, and it was being translated by a guy off stage. So I was going, hello, it's about 1,000 Moscovites, or Moscow people. Hello, how are you? Привет. Blah, 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 blah. And the gig wasn't going well. Because obviously, number one, Moscovite, but people in Moscow, generationally traumatized, you know? So then I said, oh, look, this is going shit. And then I said, this isn't really me speaking. I'm speaking through the translator. So he had to translate what I was saying. So I'm now going to pretend to be the translator. And his name is Ivan. My name is Ivan. And he suddenly was like, but it's not Ivan. I'm very lonely. But it's not lonely. When I go home, I shave mice and shove them up my asshole. And he was duty bound to translate that, right? But it's not built up. And you could see his face going fucking red. And he's so freaked out. And literally, this is how the Moscow audience reacted. Like, you know.
Oh, they were allowing themselves to release it.
Well, no, because I finally got the fucking Moscovites, man. I crashed through World War II, Stalingrad, and I connected with those bastards.
Are they really called Moscovites?
Moscolonians? Moscow.
I don't know much about much.
Yeah, so what's the most perverted thing you've ever done?
Probably urinated in someone's mouth. They did ask.
Would you like them?
That's mad. You know when you're a kid and somebody says,
"No."
It's funny, isn't it?
Depends how much.
So like to a guy,
So how much is how much?
Depends on the week.
But isn't it funny? You know the way people say they jump in the sea. It's great for the head, clears the head, or they've got a lot of anger built up and they go to the gym and they just get rid of all their anger. You know, doing weights. So for whatever reason, that person's urological chemistry, he has this idea of himself that he somehow, on some level, deserves for somebody to squat over him and piss in his mouth.
I know.
And this satisfies or releases some kind of, oh, you know, yeah. Thank God.
It gives them pleasure as well.
Yeah, it gives them pleasure. Yeah. Well, it's always, don't knock it until you try it. Do you think your mom...
No, my mom, no. She wouldn't run naked around the house either. I saw her once naked when I was 3 and she covered herself up.
Only once?
Screamed. Yeah.
Oh my goodness. I guess I haven't really seen my mom. My kids are always, because we live in an apartment.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you're not prudish. My
no, but I prefer to just be able to moisturize. Without the kids being like, hey, mom. So I'm like, just leave. They're like, yeah, I'm just going to say one thing. They just don't care. I never see them naked.
Yeah.
They're always locking themselves. Being like, don't come in.
Well, how old are they?
9 and 15.
Yeah. Well, I think at that age.
Naked time.
Yeah.
Past like 3, 4.
And it's so, I think, you know, the body, you know, at that age is a very sacred space.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what, anyway, don't get me started on fucking Catholic priests and pedophiles and all that kind of thing. I mean, there's things worse to do to people than killing them. And one of them is violating them when they're children. Hello? Okay.
Yes.
And let's move on.
Yes.
Look, you're a naturally very funny person. I like seeing you. I think you're just very exciting. So what the fuck? Why didn't that podcast... Because if the two of you saw... Listen, yeah, you might dislike each other, but obviously we've got a chemistry going here. So you can't really, you don't want to talk about what exactly, well, you don't have to tell me the exact details, but you can tell me something of it. It was some personal shit. There was some jealousies that happened.
I think there was different desires in terms of like what I am doing and what I need to do. Is just different to what she wants to do. So I think she liked the kind of, she's interested in maybe more of a, why are you pointing?
Sorry, Daniel, are you touching that microphone?
No.
Do you know something? Use Jack's microphone. I'm so sorry.
Do you have sensory issues?
Huh?
There was nothing happening.
There was nothing.
There was no sound.
Okay.
I think you have sensory issues.
In other words, did you have a bigger ambition for the podcast?
Just a different one. No. Oh, I'm not really.
Oh, she had.
I just need to speak and be me. That is my goal. That's just what I need to do. What I need to do is like, I just, everything I consume pours back out. I'm very mindful with who I am. I know who I am. I know what I'm here to do. I don't care about the influencer. Like, I don't care if a lot of people follow me. I don't care if people think I'm skinnier and hot on Instagram. That's not my thing. What my thing is just unleashing what's inside me, which is just, it has to come out. I can't even explain
it.
It's
so, you can explain. You explained it very well. And I remember talking to a performer. I can't remember his or her name. And they said, as a performer, or maybe even as an artist, you're duty bound to share whatever pops into your head. And I like that kind of freedom, that wild kind of thing where, and an audience, they might disagree with what you're saying, but they'll recognize the honesty in what you're saying, mm-hmm. which I think is so refreshing. And if you're second guessing, which is what I think you're suggesting your co-host was doing, she was sort of, you know, be careful, you can't say this or can't say that. Well, as an artist, you're definitely fucked. Because if you're second guessing what, like I did a podcast with Des Bishop and we always felt like we were one sentence away from being cancelled, you know, which was mm-hmm. a terrible way to have a conversation.
But you probably weren't going to be cancelled. You just inflicted on yourself.
Yes. And it's terrible way. If you're second guessing, I've done a few gigs like that where you're second guessing, oh, maybe they can't handle this. And it totally throws you off your game and you lose confidence completely in what you're doing.
I love it. What's
the fucking point? I don't want it. What?
I love the hate. We got cancelled. Like that actually really helped us. Within, I think, the first 3 to 4 months of having the podcast, we were sponsored by a booze company. Wouldn't dare drop the name now that they're not paying me. No, they barely even paid us at the time. But anyway, we were sponsored and then we did this ill-advised podcast.
Sorry, yeah.
And we got cancelled.
They still haven't sent us a check.
Fuck LucasAid.
I know, but why would they when you're doing it for free?
Fuck no LucasAid. It's really bad for you, but God, it's delicious.
I know there's LucasAid people and there's non-LucasAid people. I'm a non-LucasAid person. Tastes like battery acid.
Horrible.
I know what tastes like battery acid, love. Get up.
What? Now, my vagina. What's the finish that joke?
Listen.
We were cancelled very early on.
Can I ask you? Can you talk?
Can Lindsay finish the sentence?
Yeah. Can I please? Thank you, Hannah.
Because we want to know.
I'm
what
excited.
Happened.
Like it's like my birthday party, and Lindsay showed up, and I'm
just
overexcited.
Pay attention.
I am paying attention.
Yeah.
Shut the
what
f up.
What did she say?
What did I say?
She was talking about battery acid.
Listen.
Yes.
So what was the mm-hmm. thing that you said that you were cancelled about? And I think I remember it was such a non-issue.
A few different ones.
Oh right.
The first one was pretty bad.
Yeah,
can't even like.
Can we talk in the direction? We don't have to say the thing, but we're okay. What?
It was we were talking about consent, and we were kind of
okay.
So yeah, that went crazy.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I totally disagree with everything I said.
But also, to interject because I want to hear the mm-hmm. other things. You see, like, what you think is obvious to everyone might not be obvious to some people, as comedians. Sorry, excuse me, just. Sorry.
Oh my God. That's disgusting.
As comedians,
gasp being the operative word. Go
as
on.
Comedians, we will say the exact opposite to what our values are, because you should not say that. That's what is exactly funny about it, and it elevates us above the absurdity of life. So if people start taking what you're saying seriously, we're fucked. We exaggerate sometimes to make a point, or no, we don't.
No, that was more I was learning through conversation.
Okay.
Like, I mean,
So you fucked up.
It was a topic that wasn't really spoken of that much, but we're supposed to all know about consent. We spoke about it in a way that was not woke or whatever, saying things that were victim blamey. I'm a victim myself, same as every other bitch in this country. So I said wrong things. And it just went everywhere. But that cancellation propelled us. That aided us. Back then, being cancelled online was currency. So that cancellation got us everywhere.
Gotcha.
And all these little minions on Twitter who were going, like, they just helped us become more present. So that helped us. And then a few more always brought us up. So then you see people trying to get cancelled because it gets you attention.
Right.
I don't try and do that.
You mean now?
Maybe now,
I don't know. Well, every other day. Feelings.
I mean, every day now there's someone who's been cancelled, so it isn't as rare. Back then it was quite rare. Like,
and
a cancellation
I absolutely,
not often.
I'm amazed that that word has slipped into the lexicon. The lexicon, the lexicography has slipped into the, and without any disagreement or objection, canceling people. Such a psychopathic word by mean-spirited little blue-haired Trinity students who've had no life experience and are not very talented and get lots of money from mommy and daddy, and they pay rent-free and they do ketamine on the weekends, and they think if they walk around... Anyway.
Yes.
So what I'm just trying to say is that human beings will not be cancelled. We are human. We're not train journeys. You cancel a train journey. You cancel an appointment. It's a disgusting psychopathic Ted Bundy word. Stop it. And don't use ghosting either. Ghosting. Ghosting is killing somebody. Turning somebody into a ghost? You out of your fucking mind.
Why?
I'm so angry with these
people. If someone ghosts
you,
they just kind of, I guess, float away like a ghost.
Yeah, no, I just eviscerated him. Oh, did you? Yeah. I just decapitated them.
Have you been ghosted recently, David?
Oh.
Yeah, no, I was ghosted, yeah. I have ghosted people. In other words, cut people out of my life.
I don't really ghost.
Well, yeah, but you don't... There's people that you just don't talk to because they did something bad to you.
No, I still talk to them.
Oh, do you?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's fucking awesome.
I just worry that people... You know, well, they're going to die, and then I'm like, oh, what a regret.
Yeah.
So
what was the thing that you can talk about that got you other...
I got cancelled one time when I went to Cork. Was it Cork? And
you got cancelled when you went to Cork.
We did this, a show.
You know, Lindsay is so controversial. She just arrived somewhere, and then the Cork people, Jesus Christ, cancel her.
That is what happened.
We can't have this woman, this hussy, this in Cork. She will turn everyone into deviants.
I know. For a county that is so close to Cork, it's surprising how close they are. I went and I did, it was lockdown vibes.
Sorry, Cork people.
Oh, they love me. They've gotten over
it. I know, yeah.
Went down. It was lockdown, so we did one of those, like, remember those gigs that were on YouTube? There was
Zoom,
audience.
Zoom, yeah.
Something like
Zoom.
That. We did that. And then when I was, like, trying to get ready for this, like, in my own head, but we were in the green room and the window was open and I could hear echo, echo. It's the guy selling the echo papers. And then, anyway, did the gig and I left the gig and I was filming myself being like, we just did this gig for Instagram. And I could hear echo, echo. And I was like, oh my God, I want to deck that bastard who's saying that. Then I got on the train and I got a phone call like from this odd number and I picked it up and I was like, hello. And he was like, hello, this is so-and-so from the Cork BO. So we've just heard that you are threatening violence towards a disabled man.
You see, yeah.
He has a club foot, apparently.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so the thing is, a throwaway comment. There was never any intention
deck
of...
Deck the bastard. I've never decked anyone.
Yeah, but I mean, this is what I'm saying. You use comedy exaggeration. Mm-hmm. You're just expressing a frustration in that moment because it's distracting you because you've probably blah, blah, blah. And so then a small group of militant people who have nothing going on in their lives decide, oh, she wants to kill a disabled man. Yeah, that's you know what I mean?
I know.
It's funny. There used to be a guy back in Dublin. He'd sell Herald and Press, but he said it so often and for so many years that it just squeezed into editably. So it wasn't Herald or Press. Editably. So that was funny. And I certainly wanted to smash him in his Gulliver.
Yeah, it's so annoying. And then everyone's like, oh, that's a Cork tradition. Like he was a child. He's always been set. So I'm like, okay,
oh, it's
so
the same guy.
He's been a child worker and I'm the problem for saying he's annoying. You're whoring out this child selling him papers. Was he even in school? I don't know. Where did he get the club foot? Yeah. Is that from lack of Banya?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, you.
I'm not the issue here.
It's funny because Happy Dubs do that. They slip in Irish words to let you know how nationalistic they are. Yeah, just going on the
shop.
Shoving, getting a bit of Banya. There was a Happy
What's
Dub.
What's Banya?
Milk.
Oh.
There was a Happy Dub, which I was going to say, which Lindsay has got lots of. Now, come on,
happy
guys.
Happy Dub, what's that?
Happy Dub, there was a Chirpy Dub. Daniel's mate wanted to transport a couple of suitcases from here to wherever the fuck. And this chair, you know, one of these goes, you know what I mean? I'm only having a fucking laugh, you know what I mean? I fucking come on up the rah and all that shit. But meanwhile, you know, fucking coming over here, taking our jobs. But meanwhile, horrible to his fellow human beings. But we had lots of suitcases. He arrives in his van. He looks at the suitcase and he says, this isn't a fucking removal van, you know what I mean? This is a disability. And he fucked off and didn't give us a lift. Do you remember, Daniel?
Yeah.
Then we called another taxi. Polish man arrived. Dobrze, no problem. You know
Did
what I mean?
Pay him
so
well?
These Polish coming over here, thank God they're coming over here and making this country a better country, you fucking
No,
cunts.
You can say you idiots.
We're about to get popular.
Yes.
You
keep saying it. Keep saying
yeah,
it. More,
come on.
More.
Okay, I'll cut that out. Okay.
How much do you hate them? What?
I was just going. No, but anyway. So, but yes. So it's.
I don't know much about Irish history, but I did have a funny joke. I haven't done it yet because I think it is one that people wouldn't like. And again, I don't really know much about Irish history, but a friend of mine was talking to me the other day and he had like all these tattoos and he had one of Bobby Sands. And I was like, are you for real having one of Bobby Sands? Isn't he just a famous anorexic? But I think that's a bad... I don't know much, but...
Well, I remember Bobby Sands. I remember back in the 80s. And
what, did you meet him?
I remember back in the 80s and we'd all wear black armbands, you know, because that was when the IRA, it was at its kind of most... sort of credible, you know. I mean, the idea of, I've gone on a 5-day Apple diet. I'm not going to say that, compare myself to fucking hunger strikers.
Yeah, it's just like, David. And I don't think that Republic of Ireland supported them, did they?
Oh, yeah, they did. The Republic of Ireland did. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
No, not really, though.
Not like south of Dublin.
There's no proper support.
Did you hear the IRA opened a new restaurant? Do you know what it's called?
What?
When hunger strikes.
You.
That's John Cleary's joke.
It's funny.
Were you freaked out?
I can't believe you give out to Hannah for tapping the mic and you're like spluttering with that vape.
Yeah, yeah. Yep.
So hypocritical.
Yeah.
So hypocritical. I can't believe it.
Were you fucked off by the fact that you had to stop doing that podcast because it reached it got so successful?
Yeah, it was so annoying. I'd gotten used to a wage that I never thought I'd have.
Right.
And then that wage was gone and I was like, what the fuck? It's so much easier to get used to having money than to get used to not having money. I was used to for years. I was like a single mom living off loan parent payment grant. I was bopping around, grand, kids fucking a few things under the buggy for free, just used to my life. Yeah. And then I made loads of money in 2 years. I was like, this is great. I had this sense of like power gone. And she pisses off with her fiance, who is like a photographer. So I'm giving the kids the fucking phone to try and get photos for my Instagram. Genuinely, I give Luna €2 toka boca for fucking content. Because I don't like asking my friends, and you know,
is there no other person you could have similar chemistry with that you could start it up? Or did you think about that? Did you try and start?
I have my friend Shauna,
yeah,
who I found after the split. And see, the thing with me and my ex co-host was we didn't have a lot of the same life experience.
But was that why it worked? Maybe because of the tension. No,
I felt that there. So I found Shauna and she's kind of similar to me. She just spills all. She has no shame. She just doesn't care if she's seen as attractive or whatever. Like, so she's great. She's someone who I do podcasts a lot with and shows.
Oh, so sorry. Excuse me. Do you have a new podcast?
Yes.
What's it called?
Only on Patreon.
Oh.
Lipstick Lessons. But I'm changing it to Lil Lippy.
Lipstick Lessons.
Yeah,
and how's it going?
It's going good.
Yeah, yeah.
It's great. Like, I mean... I do it every week. I have a WhatsApp group for all the girls.
How long have you been doing it?
Like a year and a half, maybe.
Great.
2 years.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's so, like, I'm at home with the kids full time and I'm able to do my little pod.
Yeah.
I've barely worked, really.
Well, that's working.
It is working, but I've barely, like, done normal jobs. I don't really like that kind of... I stay up till 4 a.m. working most nights.
Did you ever think about doing OnlyFans?
Yes.
Did you?
Yeah.
Oh.
But instead, I've thought about it, but like my mum and dad that would be the nail in the coffin. They'd probably try and take the kids off me.
Do you want to do it or you don't want to do it?
I want the money.
Okay, right.
I don't want to show my vagina that much. I mean, I don't really care, but like if it got me a lot of money, I definitely would love to do it. But it would just be the kind of residual, the trauma it would cause my family, the kids getting slagged, blah, 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 blah. So instead, I sell my socks the odd time.
Say that again, Lindsay.
Sell socks.
I sell socks sometimes.
Oh, that you've worn.
Knickers, whatever.
And
men like to do things.
On OnlyFans, so.
Look at Hannah's thinking.
Actually,
ka-ching.
No, I was just like, because
one of the guys.
So many weird people.
Twitter is the place. We can talk afterwards if you're interested.
Mm-hmm. And you know, like I heard about this woman. She gets men
to come
over to her place and clean her house.
Yes.
They pay her
and
clean her house.
Oh,
I've done that.
They're called pig pays. Pay pigs.
Like to be called slaves. I mean.
Older men who get young girls
older.
To treat
they're
them
they're not
like
older
shit.
All the time.
Oh, right.
Not necessarily older. They just like
all
to
shapes
be
and
mistreated.
Sizes and ages.
Clean their houses and still pay for them. Being really rude to them.
So
I love it.
Lindsay, like at the moment how long have you been doing stand-up?
Our first show? We did a live shows together.
Who?
Me and Jenny. So that was like in the Eagles days.
Pre-COVID? Or?
Yeah. But that's not stand-up. That's you doing your podcast. I mean...
It was stand-up.
Oh, you were doing stand-up?
Yeah.
Okay. So the feeling...
That's what I was told afterwards. I didn't really know.
The feeling I get from you is that you want to get to a place where you can tour as Lindsay Hamilton doing a show.
Yes.
But the pain in the arse of being in the trenches for years, doing all these shitty little gigs, you don't want to go through that.
Oh, I do want to go through that.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Okay.
I want to do that.
Why did I get
wanna,
that impression? Oh, what?
I don't want to... be pals with the comedy scene. I don't like that vibe.
The comedies. Go on.
Fucking.
What do you mean?
I just.
Yeah, yeah.
I find a lot of the comedy scene. There's like maybe three who are genuinely funny. There's a lot of people who want to be comedians who are not funny.
Yeah. Well, I mean that's the whole. There are very few comedians who hit the ground running. I mean, hit the ground running. That's such a kind of, I don't know, phrase. But like Tommy Tiernan, I guess you could say did. Dylan Moran, Phil Kay. Joanne McNally didn't. Deirdre Kane. You know, they had to put in a X number of years.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
What about yourself?
Oh, fuck. I'm still, I'm not, I only, I sort of kind of, you know. But
it's because you're not working hard?
Well, listen, I got into comedy. I didn't want to. Listen, my point is, well, no, I did The Savage Eye when I was 40. So that was like after...
Was
13, 15, 15 years of working my ass off.
Mm.
Well, street performing. You know, I did street performing for too long, Hannah. I was sinning against my talent. It was just providing me with allowing me to sustain a lifestyle. And it was just, and I could goof off for most of the time. And I was a fucking
alcoholic.
So
that's what you mean,
and I was
you
drinking.
Didn't work.
I didn't work, yeah.
Hmm.
Loads of people don't work, you know, but now I understand the importance of fucking hard work. Okay.
But
I think it's focus.
For you, it's different because you've already got an audience and everything. So it you can't really go through the same thing.
I think so.
Which is a good thing, I think, you know.
In a way. I did a show in Galway last and I did a show in Bray and they weren't people. I think there was a handful of people who knew me, but then there was just a load of random men. So that was a new challenge because I was used to just having females listen to me for so long.
Mm-hmm.
Was the It Gals podcast majority female?
In our shows we sold at Vicar Street like three times and it was all women, the odd gay.
Well, that's fucking amazing, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just such a pity that you didn't continue it or
I
it
mean,
isn't.
I don't think it's too much of a pity.
But, you know, that's what John McCauley does.
Joanne McNally.
McNally, yes. So
see, I purposely don't watch her and other...
In case you pick up...
Yeah, I'm so absorbative.
Right, yes.
If I hang out with someone with a posh accent, I will sound like that within 20 minutes.
Right.
I go to England for a weekend and come back. I'm like, I just... So I have to be very concise with who I listen to.
No, I understand. I understand.
And who
that.
I watch
yeah,
and what
yeah.
I absorb.
Mm.
I can't... watch the
you're
news.
You're like a comedic tampon.
Yes. Very, very with everything. You love tampons.
No, because you were talking about
them. I know, they freak me out. I like pads. I like seeing what's happening.
Yeah, yeah.
Is there an arm in that pad? Is that a period or a miscarriage?
Who knows?
And I also had this thought that if you put tampons up every month, your vagina would get bigger.
That's so true.
Don't you have to do your Kegel exercises?
I'm doing them right now.
What are they? me too. What it, explain, you have to explain, your explain vagina. Hannah, what a Kegel muscle exercises is.
But apparently they're not always the best. What you have to actually do to strengthen your pelvic floor.
Yeah.
By doing Pilates or squeezing or certain exercises.
You should toil your pelvic floor. What?
yeah, just make it really strong.
Did you give birth vaginally?
Yes. Dill. And, you know, and there are consequences.
Do you think, oh, did you have hard births?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Did you?
No. Fell out. Grand.
Mm.
What do you mean? You didn't have you didn't have to have an episiotomy.
No, is that when they cut the?
Mm-hmm.
I wrote down, "Do not do that."
What did Robbie Williams say about his? He said, "It was like watching his favorite pub being burnt down."
Isn't that the most horrific thing ever? Like, oh, fuck off, Robbie.
Yeah, yeah.
Piss off! I saw him at the Three Arena. When he played last, terrible. I was like dying to see Robbie Williams. I was like, what a gifted performer. Years ago when he did Slain, like amazing. Oh, he looked like Aladdin. He was wearing like gold lamé. He had a weird little mullet. And then he kept on like being side of stage, being like, in 1998, I was one of the first guys. And like just basically sucking his own cock for the entire thing. I was like, just sing Angels. Pathetic 50-year-old overweight women bopping away, being like, he's gorgeous.
You do a good impression. Oh, yeah, he's
it was like
that.
Ricky Gervais. It was like a parody.
You are right. That it's like from the male perspective, describing the vagina as, you know, because it takes quite a battering during birth.
This is why I'd like to start an OnlyFans, because mine is absolutely fabulous.
Yeah.
And any time post being a mum, I'm sure you know when you've not stayed with the dad, guy goes in there, oh, you're really tight. Surprised. It's a fucking muscle. It goes back.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's just, I mean.
Okay, Robbie Williams.
Yeah, Robbie Williams, like get your foreskin out. Oh. Let's see that.
Yeah, let's see your
foreskin. Because if it's anything to do with the rest of him, he's not keeping that intact.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And terrible tattoos.
Yeah, yeah. What was his big hits?
Angels.
Anus.
That one. You think that you're strong.
He was Rock kind DJ. Of
like, oh, that one was freaky when he took his muscles off. Remember, I hated that video.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
He takes his bum cheeks off. He's such a nudist.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'd say he's bi and he's just like, that's why he said that. Like, oh, my fucking favorite pub is Gary Barlow's dick.
Well, you know, it's funny. Yeah, is he still? It's interesting. So you said you saw Robbie Williams in whenever, and now you saw him. Is he still trying to cling to what he was? Is he as opposed to he hasn't sort of moved on or tried to do something more appropriate for what he can do now or something?
Yeah, I think he's like he was talking about Take That, talking about how amazing he was that he had left, and that he was talking about how he wove in like drug use into songs that were then being played on the radio. And he was very proud of that, going on and on how sober he is when like you could quite visibly see the powders around his nostril. Like, I mean, if he's sober.
So well, he also doesn't you can be but he just sniffs.
What about
you can be a drunk, sober person.
Do you drink, Lindsay?
Every day.
What's your favorite drink?
Bulmer's Light or a margarita.
why do you laugh when you say that?
Bulmer's Light. I just drink wine. I can't drink wine. I'll do crazy shit.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, well, it gets into your head really fast, doesn't it?
Yeah, like everyone's always like,
isn't margarita,
you drink cider.
Hasn't margarita got tequila in it?
Yes.
Yeah,
and that doesn't affect you in that way.
It does, but I don't mind. Cause
when you say crazy shit, you mean having sex with people you normally wouldn't have sex with when you're sober?
I mean, I'd say more so I probably have been taken advantage of by men because I'm so drunk. Not that I'm opting in to have sex with them because I'm drunk. Do you know what I mean? You know what I mean?
What?
Well, you said taken advantage of, but obviously you want it as well.
Not always.
Are you just struggling?
Oh, not Jesus always. Christ.
No, see, you know. Can't handle real talk and you're like, oh, I'm so open and real.
No, because we're talking about somebody being taken advantage of.
Okay, what do I do? If I am really drunk, I get angry. Like a couple of weeks ago, I was in my local pub and for the first time ever, I did mushrooms.
Oh, yeah, Hannah's
They're
into that.
Great. Oh, my God, I love them.
Hannah microdoses. Do you?
See, I full dose. Well, that's what I. Yeah. None of this micro
Jesus
shit.
Jesus Christ, you're some hardcore.
Oh, it was great.
You're so tough or something. And Hannah. Hannah. No, but you are. Like, you're like the two of you are like Keith Richards. You're like, I am, take me to the hospital. I can't handle anything. But you guys are like, oh, no problem, fucking microdose. You know.
Yeah.
You see, so if I was younger and hanging out with you, I'd be thinking, oh, yeah, I'm going to do what she does. And then I'd have a panic attack.
You end up in a mental hospital.
So go on. You were on your. You did a full dose.
Well, I'd never taken them before, and I hate mushrooms in general, just like as a food.
Mm.
But my friend had them, so we took them, and I just was like, I turned into my daughter. My daughter is this really charismatic person, and I was just slagging every man in the pub and having a great old time. I turned into even more of a cunt. I was surprised.
But when you just to go back, and it is a land, landmines and all that.
Yeah.
When you say you drink wine, you can be taken advantage of. Like Hannah's point is that, you mean it just makes you more inhibited and you have sex with people that you aren't that attracted to.
Is that
what you mean?
This happens a lot in Ireland for men and women. I think that drunk people can be... If you were putting yourself, not like this is where it came sometimes with this conversation when we were doing when we got cancelled, which I've grown from in... the conversation, there's all like, you know, I knew people when I was hanging around with gay guys, I knew people who would leave the gay bar to go searching around Temple Bar for straight men who were really, really drunk because they could bring them back and convince them to do whatever.
Oh, I know there are. I know a few gay guys who really get
obsessed
off
with straight men and all this bollocks.
Yeah, but do you think they are straight men if they can be? Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
If they're you know, looking for someone drunk. It's like any kind of abuse.
I don't
of
care
person.
How drunk I am. If some gay dude's coming up to me,
but like what
that,
if I don't
that's
know?
That's never
happens.
Gonna.
Yeah, but if you know, like if you really drunk.
What I'm talking about is R
some drugs. No. You know, inhibition. A lot of time, inhibition goes.
Yeah.
And people are willing to do things.
But
well,
I like that
rape.
About drink.
That's the word. That's the word. It is. See, you can say I wouldn't do that. But some people specifically target really, really drunk people because they know that they won't remember or they know that they can say it in a different way or whatever.
And you think,
that's what happens with me and wine.
That happens to who and who?
Me on wine or me on certain drinks. You know, I'm just...
So
you can just fall asleep.
Yeah.
So you know, if you're born in certain type of boobs, even if you put on weight...
I want yours.
No, I put on weight and they don't grow bigger.
Really? Mine just, the fat doesn't know where to go, so it just
comes out here.
But that's the right place for fat to go.
Yes, I would love to be a wet nurse.
That's amazing. What an amazing gift you've been given, that when you put on weight, it goes to your tits.
Amazing.
I guess so.
You guess so?
They're difficult to dress.
Okay, well, shut up.
They honestly are.
Lindsay, you're being disingenuous.
No, I'm not.
You're saying that you're not excited, the fact that if you put on weight, it goes to your tits. Because like mine goes to my belly. Be like a guy putting on weight and making his dick bigger. Fucking elephant trunk.
Yeah, but you can't complain about tits in this country. They're like, I are lucky to have them. Every single model had no tits.
Yeah.
Kate Moss, Giselle maybe a B. Yeah. Like... Big
but
tits aren't really
tune.
Represented.
Nowadays, models are a bit different, you know?
A little bit. I think the Kardashians, I guess, changed the body.
Can I
image.
Just say, the reason I liked drinking was that it sort of opened my field of vision in terms of what I found attractive. So therefore, someone that I wouldn't go near when I was very drunk, I'd be really into that. I'd find like, you know, maybe her ear, and I'd be like, oh, this sexy ear. And I'd focus in, I'd focus in on that. and you know what I mean? Obviously, and then it's kind of like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. You're in this throes of being possessed. And then you wake up the next morning and you're like, and obviously vice versa, you know, because, you know, I've been in situations where women have woken up next to me and just thought, oh, Jesus Christ.
What have I done?
What have I done?
Do you prefer to wake up in their house or to wake up in your house?
Oh, you mean the walk of shame.
I prefer to wake up in theirs because you can leave immediately.
Yeah.
All I'm trying to say is that every Irish mother and father got together originally when they were pissed. I'm sure I was conceived when my mother and father were drunk. I mean, we have an inability to, do the first kiss thing, or you know, show affection.
You're brave, all
so a drink is the social lubricant that Irish people seem to need to get them to fall in each other's direction. But people do take advantage. Who's taking advantage?
It's a complicated one. It's definitely a complicated one.
Yeah, but most people know. What?
I mean, it's complicated because the conversation now is like, if someone is drunk and you're having sex with them, that you're taking advantage of them. But what if you're also drunk and it was a both drunk decision? So it's complicated.
What were the discussions or conversations that got people most, you know, people were most into in your podcast?
I guess dating culture.
Okay.
I would call myself, I think I have good experience with men.
So give us
all
some
different types.
Did you go on a lot of dates?
I think so. I just know men. I feel like I get men. I understand how to work them, and I can help other women in dating. Some women just are like, oh, should I do this? I don't know how, but I just know how to.
So can you give us some examples for some? Oh, yeah. So, in other words, so what would the kind of advice that a young woman would say in terms of dating?
A lot of the time it's quite obvious cheating that these guys are doing. And the woman is like,
is he cheating or is he not
cheating? Yeah, there's now a Facebook page actually that is called Are We Dating the Same Man? And it's all Dublin people. I think thousands of women on this page. They match with someone on Tinder and then you put his face on Facebook and say, any tea ladies. You're not allowed to say, and you have to specifically say something like that. Any tea on this man. And then underneath every photo, I've been dating him, I've been doing this, I'm sucking him off currently, I'm pregnant. Crazy.
Well, in the United States, dating, you date multiple people until you get one serious.
That happens here too, but the men just don't tell you.
Oh, right. Yeah, yeah. And are you currently in
a
relationship?
No, I was just asking, do women do the same thing?
Women a lot of the time do it more so just writing. Like they'd be maybe flirting on Instagram with someone. Mm. Or kind of liking someone's pictures. Men are more like getting.
And can I ask you? Can I ask you? Are you in a relationship at the moment?
If I was on Facebook, it would be an it's complicated.
Okay, what does this complicated mean?
Well, I was in a long distance relationship for a year. He's from New York,
so he must have a very long penis.
Oh yes.
Sorry.
Did you ever meet him?
Long distance. Okay, I'm unfurling it now. It'll be there in an hour and a half.
Because I know a girl who has a long distance relationship for 2 years and she haven't ever met him yet in person.
Oh, no.
Who's, do we know?
No, you don't know. But like she, obviously they have Zoom calls, but they never met in person.
See, I would not be doing that. We saw each other every month.
Okay.
For a year. But then I just want to be on my own for a little while.
Yeah, to sort of.
I need to focus on my comedy. Good, I can't have any. Well, unless you are literally hyping me up. Even some close friends, if they're like, oh, don't say that, gone.
Well, I'm going to introduce you to Eddie Malarkey and Damo Clack.
Cannot wait.
Who run the Crack Den. That's a good place to go. I think it runs Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And it's a good place to go and fail miserably in front of a disinterested audience.
Okay, fab. Because I think Galway was a difficult one.
You mean
a gig? There's not a lot of cocaine in Galway. So some of my cocaine jokes fell a bit flat.
Cocaine is all over fucking Galway. And is that
Galway is a drug?
I swear to God, a friend of mine asked every single person in Galway. She got kicked out of fucking everywhere.
Do you know that street? There's a street in Galway. No, there where all the college students live. You know?
Yeah. I said, what was the
place? How does he fucking know, Anna?
I don't know. Somebody told me.
I know.
If I find out any of you two guys are doing cocaine, sweet mother of divine Jesus. You're disowned.
Thank God. I'd be happy.
I listen. Rack them up now. There, let's
you're
go.
You're disowned, David. So you know, do you people, should have some sympathy.
Have you ever done it?
I did it when I was in New York once. And
but
geez.
Do people still do cocaine?
It's huge right now.
It's huge. And the kind of cocaine you get in Galway, it's not like Dublin cocaine. There's bits of fucking dry stone wall and fucking smoke.
It's like
salmon. You know what I mean? Sniff a bit of that. You know, a bit of an old donkey's fucking leg in it.
Everyone does it. It's literally everywhere.
Yeah, I mean, it's extraordinary. Coke, the thing that's very annoying is you meet somebody, and you meet somebody. No, you know, in the evening, and they're like, "Oh yeah, absolutely, yeah, great, absolutely, yeah." And you think, "God, that guy's so upbeat. He's so, you know, got a great personality." You meet the guy the next day, and there's nothing there. He's got no personality, and the little bit of personality that he has is a load of shit anyway. It's fucking, it's unbelievable. Do you know these fuckers?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, absolutely, yeah. Oh, definitely. They definitely won't. They never do, and it's all talk. But I was.
Were
that,
you like so. That? What were you like as an alcoholic? How many years were you drinking?
7 years, thank you.
Only seven?
I don't know.
I stopped in 2003 and then had a slip in 2014.
And were you married?
Oh, geez.
For how long?
Oh, we were married for quite a long time because we got divorced like a few years ago.
10 years ago?
No, but we got divorced just on paper.
Oh,
like
yeah.
2019, I think, or 2020.
But we love each other more now, don't we?
But we split up 2010.
But we're okay. We're Jack and Daniel's mother and father, and we're tighter as a family than we ever have been. And we love each other because we're not together.
Yes, I love that. I was saying I love the showing a different family dynamic.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But you still see each other like daily all
yeah,
the time?
Yeah, yeah. We talk to each other every day.
Yeah, but like in spurts. Like we don't stay with each other for a very long time. Because, you know, it's a difficult person.
Yeah, I know.
You know, and you...
Go on, yeah, yeah.
And, you know, like, maybe you don't need to spend too much time, mm-hmm. you know? It's rather shorter, but more intense.
I'm very grateful for my relationship with Hannah, and I really appreciate her a lot. And I love the fact, you know, Jack and Daniel, I don't know, just maybe a year ago, I suddenly realized that, you know, life, you know, I've lived a lot of my life, and I want to just remain close and see my sons and have a good relationship with them. That's why I love doing this.
It is podcast, great. I love it.
Blah 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 blah.
Have
blah,
you?
Blah, blah, blah.
I have questions for you now. Has it been difficult to date because of the close relationship that you have? Do men find that difficult?
He doesn't have a problem. David doesn't have a problem dating women, mm-hmm. but men I'm meeting, they're just jealous. They don't want me. So I'm just thinking, what am I doing? Am I cutting off possible relationships? Or, and then again I'm thinking,
oh, women have been jealous of my relationship with you.
Yeah, but like they know that.
why does that make you laugh, Jen?
I don't know.
I think it's just funny, probably. Well, like when you know your relationship and it's so difficult when people come in and they're jealous and you're like, how can I explain that there really is not
Well, we've known each other for 32 years.
Yeah, like I was dating this guy and he wanted me to take down all the films I made with David. And I'm just like...
On Instagram.
And I've done it for so, you know, for so long.
Oh, and like Hannah came to me and said, can you take that?
No, I wasn't crying. No.
But you wanted to do it.
Yeah,
It's just control. Yeah. Men want to own women. Yeah, they want you to be. I've had that issue for years with men. Every single man.
You don't seem to be the kind of person that would put up with that for a split.
Everyone says that to me.
But you are.
Oh, yes. So you're
real softy.
I think because I'm quite hard on the outside, but it's quite like, because maybe that's a cover for vulnerability, and men always spot the little vulnerability.
So you fall madly in love with this guy?
I respond well to love bombing.
What is love bombing?
Love bombing is like first 2 weeks where they're like, I've never felt this connection, oh my God. And then they're like buying you gifts and it's just like, I can't even go a day without seeing you, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I did back a couple of days ago. I definitely would have fallen for that. Not anymore. You see, I used to be a man eater, but now I'm only saying this because it rhymes. I'm going to be a man beater. Every man who's fucked me over.
Payback. How did you do that? How did you transform yourself? How did you transgress from this sort of falling for a man easily to the one who...
I dated so many different men.
Yeah, okay.
So many different men.
That's interesting.
All the same thing. The same issues.
Oh.
Fascinated by me. Oh, wow, I love your style. You're crazy. You're so this. But then they want me to change.
So when did a penny drop?
Oh, wait a second. You mean so many different types of men? Do you mean physically different?
Physically,
or emotionally?
Personalities. Everything was so... You would never... They have nothing in common.
You mean career and wise mm-hmm. and all that, but it ended up the same things happening.
Yes.
But is that not reflective of you?
I'm the common denominator, yes. But I think men have an issue with just controlling women.
With jealousy.
To own women.
So if a guy got close to you and you were talking to another guy, he'd be jealous kind of thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Or if I'm up on stage talking about that kind of stuff.
Well, I've told you that story about me and Fiona O'Shaughnessy and we went out.
Love name dropping her. Oh my God.
Because I love Fiona so much and I'm so glad she's
because
in my
life. Because she's hot and you just want to be like, reminder everyone.
I do speak fluent name
That's
drop.
That's why you have Hannah on here.
I speak
fluent. Reminder everyone.
I want to say this. I speak fluent name drop. I'm seeing Martin McDonagh next week. Now listen. I was so mental about Fiona.
Yeah.
That we went on this weekend, and we were walking down this country road, and this horse came up to her, and she started talking to the horse, and she was all like that, and the horse was nibbling at her, and something was happening to me, and then later I had a panic attack, and I only realized like 5 years later I was jealous of the fucking horse.
Yeah, I think she.
I'm out of my fucking mind, man. So I mean, mm-hmm. like I'm gone. Like I mean, thank God now over time. I'm just, you know, I understand that you love the person with an open hand.
And you don't want anything.
And you let them
return.
Gravitate towards you organically. And you don't try and control because the exact opposite to what you think is going to happen will happen. I mean, it's crazy. And it's a really unpleasant, horrible state of mind to be in. And also this idea also of, you know, you're the one. No such thing. And it's almost replaced fucking religion. It's psychosis, believing that the person you're with is the one. And I see a lot of couples and they're in that awful fucking bubble. Mm. And they're just like, they're just like stuck together like fucking.
But you know what, Fiona made you, I mean, she should get a medal. You know, like David never goes on public buses. And she made him to go with her on public buses and drive for hours.
Was this after you were married?
Yeah. Like okay. They were going out with each other, Fiona O'Shaughnessy and David. And then I was laughing so much because like
me and Fiona, me and Fiona have such a good time. We're such good friends and I'm so glad She's that lovely. We are in each other's lives. And, you know, so I just talk about it because it was a very significant relationship.
It's good that you recognize that you were jealous, though. It's because it comes from the ego. Oh, a lot of men don't even realize.
Right. A lot of men don't probably realize. Mm-hmm. And it's this kind of, you know, it's blind and it's so unpleasant and it shuts people down.
And he would say, oh, I'm not jealous. Aren't you want to be my girlfriend? Do you want to be like Mrs. Ex-wife?
What is jealousy from? You say ego, what do you mean?
I mean, especially now that everything's online. So if I'm doing, say, a comedy set, a lot of it is quite provocative and stuff. Mm. I have one joke.
But
because
that's not you, go on. Really. I
mean, no, but
yeah,
it doesn't
it's not mean, a big...
But so what if it's... Say whatever you... Sorry.
But I mean, so I think men have always found that difficult. Like I had one joke a while ago in Galway. I was talking about both my kids have English dads and I've found English people to be very stingy. So the joke is something like... English men are so stingy, the only thing they've ever given me is ejaculation. And then this guy was just like, oh, I don't like that. They don't like that I'm up there talking about someone else ejaculating inside of me and making a child. That's embarrassing because it just embarrasses them. It unsettles them. But then men, you're walking down the street and they're ogling at some bitch. I'm like, I'm looking at cars. You can look at asses all day. I'm looking at cars and watches.
Because they're thinking, oh, when my mates see this, they're going to rinse me about that.
And they will.
Yeah. And they're also, men are also insecure because they're aware of how they think. And, you know, we all kind of think the same. So when men are jealous in a relationship, you know, they see them talking to another guy, they're kind of in their head, they're thinking, well, I know what I'd be thinking if I was talking to this girl as well.
Yeah.
You know, and men don't care if a girl's in a relationship or if she's, you know, if she's giving them something, you know.
I think it emasculates them if you're talking to another man.
So
ego.
Have you got like red lines now? Red lines in terms of relationships? If
flags or whatever.
Are you still
I think for the foreseeable, I'm just happy
to be single.
Yeah, there's not many relationships that I'm like, oh, I'd love that. I live on my own with the two kids. I just, in the evening, I do whatever I want. So the long distance relationship helped me.
What?
The long distance relationship helped me with that.
Don't talk over me.
You talked over me, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. Supposed to be a host and listening.
He's very bold.
No.
Do you remember the time I was helping you set up Patreon and you wouldn't give me your laptop? And I was like trying to, you were just...
Oh, yeah.
I was like, can I just do it? And you were like, cookies. Should I accept cookies?
I know.
Did you think? A little McVitie was just going to come out of the Mac.
No, but you know, because I'm an older dude, man. And
I know, but look at all this.
I was brought up in the 70s and 80s, dude. You know. And I remember I was out with this young one on a date. And exactly like that. And I was, you know the way young people, when they're sending texts, yeah. It's all like this. Look, it's all like, yeah. And they speak so fast, yeah. Some people speak so fast. Some young men and women speak so fast. Yeah, and it's almost like they're trying to distract you from the fact that they don't really have anything to say, but they're trying to sound like they're really fucking interesting. And it's like, what? What did you say? And then the other people around them, oh yeah, tell me what's your problem? But right, it's all that going on. And then I'm talking like this, but then young people, when they're sending texts, and then I was sitting with your one and I went like this, look. Like that, like an old fucking hen pecking away at the fucking thing, and your one's vagina must have just gone
shut down.
Up the fucking moon, gone, see ya, fuck off.
Yeah, but that's kind of annoying if she was texting on the date anyway.
No, I was texting like that.
Oh, but was
no, I, she, I'm,
why were you texting on the date?
I wasn't, I was just reacting to something or whatever.
Like, why were you reacting to someone else's story on a date with a girl?
No, you probably were texting.
Whatever. I'm just saying, listen, what the fuck?
I just, that's annoying. If you're on a date
red
with
someone. Well, I don't even know if you understood what I just said, because you've just gaslighted me.
I'm breadcrumbing you right now.
Hey, you are breadcrumbing me.
Yeah.
Why did you do that? Do you know what you're doing? You're window painting me. Mm-hmm. Okay, listen, Another ick was, and I might have said this before, there was a girl, right, and I was sitting over there, and then she went out of the room for a few minutes, and then she came back and pretended like she hadn't seen me in 10 years, and then she pretended to be all like a child or something, and she just looked at me and went hi. And I had a visceral, it just went hoo! It was all, wah! Wah! Like, I mean,
yes.
I couldn't see her ever again. I had to get her out, get fuck off. Oh shit.
Oh, Hannah would be on the floor if she did that.
Yeah, I'd be beaten.
Yeah, to a pulp.
Sorry, guys.
Sit yourself down. What's one of your icks?
What's one of yours, though?
Oh, God.
What's happened to you that a guy's done that and you just think, ah, good luck?
I had an ex who was obsessed with like me not showing my cleavage. And every time he'd bend over, I'd see his ass crack. That really fucking pissed me off.
Oh my God.
So because the weight of these things, I would wear a top to here, but they just kind of, like, you can't, like, so he'd always hoosh up my tops if we're out, like, hooshing up my top. And then I'm like, I can see the hair crawling out of your crack, but this is an issue. What's the difference? They literally look the same by the hair.
If mm-hmm. by the way, you put on weight on your tits, would you not, do you not feel the urge to eat more food?
Sorry, Jack. That's so stupid. Oh, because like you're like massive. Jack,
that was in my head as well. Yeah.
Yeah, I'll just be kicking them in the door next time I'm here. Ka-dunk, ka-dunk, ka-dunk.
It's mad, isn't it? It's like a superpower. Tit woman.
Yeah, I saw on Facebook. Stop. On Instagram, there was this woman doing tricks with her boobs and just like hitting people like. With the
there was a great
opening the door.
I'd love to. A great stopper. Mine could be a good door stopper.
There was a great film called Birdie with Matthew Modine. You know,
he already said it.
He was obsessed. Yeah, but he went out on a date, and this girl liked him, and she showed him her tits. And but he was so into birds, he just couldn't really relate to human beings, and he just like holding it and just going, you know what I mean? It's funny. It's funny how they are so electrifying to men.
But it is nourishment,
like tits. Like ooh, like tits, you know what I mean? Ooh.
But it is nourishment. I breastfed for like 3 years.
Amazing.
3 to 4, well, different babies.
So your kids come in the door, Mom, I'm hungry.
Oh, it was the best, the weight loss.
Huh?
when I was breastfeeding, I was at my skinniest because they just suck out calories.
Yes.
Fabulous. Obsessed. That's why I want to be a wet nurse.
Yeah, yeah.
You can get like hormones injected that you're lactating again.
Is that right?
I'd lactate men. I wouldn't care. I'm sure there's a market for that.
Definitely. Yeah, there'd be guys out there who'd be happy.
I think I'm looking right at one.
Well, there'd be guys out there. There'd be guys out there.
Latching on.
There'd be guys out there who would love to latch on.
It'd be great. They could pay me. I'd be losing the weight.
Well, what would you charge for this service?
I think I'd need
a lot of money.
I don't know. I'd have to reach out to a few women and be like, what do you be charging for that now? You know? And then I'd
just to be on top I'm of trying the to game.
Think, yeah.
I've tasted, well, I remember in Sydney, you were expressing your breast milk.
Yeah.
I think I tasted once or something. Just
yeah, so. They don't really.
It tastes sweet.
It tastes sweet, and it's does also it? Quite thin as well. It's yes. not. It's certainly the early tit milk
yes.
is very thick, is it?
No, the colostrum, I think it's called.
Oh, yeah, colostrum.
Because it's fat. It fattens up the baby.
Yeah. So you're thinking.
But they're lured in by the sweet taste.
So there you have it, folks. Like, if anybody's interested, Lindsay will happily yes. breastfeed you for a price.
Price to be announced, guys.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how long would the session last for? Sorry.
Well, this was all the favorite boob because it used to be pierced, so more comes
out. Right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
Yeah. And then this is my bigger. Do you have a bigger
like
boob?
A sprinkler?
No. Not yeah. Really.
Do you know what it feels like? Do you know what this conversation?
A fire be- gone.
Do you know what this? Do you know what this conversation feels like? It's like Sunday dinner, and some you know, and the guy brings his girlfriend, mom, and and she's talking about breast milk, and she says something really honest and open, and it just.
It's hell.
Yeah.
I can't help myself.
But I remember when I was breastfeeding at the beginning, my boobs were like
massive.
Two cabbages. My God. I was looking down rocks. And I could
they were like rocks.
Not
yeah, yeah.
believe the size of them.
And everyone, because everyone's coming over to see the baby. Like I remember my uncle being like, oh, gee, oh, like, because they were two squares. Yeah. And I was like, there's nothing
could
I can
float
do.
Float on them. It's like a floating device.
But it is. I remember when Daniel was born, we were living in Hamlinsgale. And Hannah was, she's lying in bed and the boob is out. Daniel is half asleep but latched on and sort of sleeping and drinking at the same time. And then, you come back into the room and you just look at this scene in your bed and it's just quite amazing.
Like, amazing. I wasn't sure where you're going to go.
No.
It's very cute.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Where did you think
I
was going
to go?
I
thought you were like, it's disgraceful. Like when I was breastfeeding, because that was before I was driving, I was breastfeeding on the bus. I was breastfeeding everywhere.
No, it's the most beautiful thing. It just makes you realize, like, the mother, it's kind of like she's everything. She's like the... she's
like a milking machine.
Well, no, but you're providing nourishment, warmth,
yes.
everything. You're like a mobile everything or something.
It's crazy. And the saliva, the baby saliva goes into the nipple and tells the woman what to make. So if they're sick, it makes those antibiotics, like whatever.
Okay, it was like a religious scene.
Mm.
It was like, what was that thing where Jesus is and the steam from the donkey's nose is keeping the baby warm? What's the
what
the fucking manger for fuck's
oh,
sake?
Oh, the yeah the
oh whatever.
What listen, was it the inn? But it wasn't the inn.
It was a very
stable.
It felt like quite a profound experience, and just to see that it was and you're that's in your bed,
I'm surprised you only tasted it worse. Loads of people tasted mine. I was working and I'd have to like express in the staff room.
What
the girls
staff
would
room?
Be trying it. I was doing nails.
The girls would be trying it.
Yeah.
You mean opening?
Well, one girl in particular
opening her mouth.
Well, I just put it into one of the cups. Then I'll be going out drinking and like expressing into cocktail glasses and pig.
Drips.
Yeah, because I read like you could drink. So that
yeah,
I wouldn't have done
it
as long.
For you.
Shuts the baby up.
So any how long have you been broadcasting for, Daniel? Broadcasting.
Hour 18
wow,
minutes.
Wow, it's flown by. It's
good
so
grief.
Much fun talking to you. It's just amazing. No, I love it. I know, I love it. And so that you're doing
love
this.
Love being here.
Well, I think I like you more than you like me. I think that's obvious.
I don't think so.
I think so.
I think I had to triple text to get a response, but.
No, I think, listen, but you are naturally very, very funny. And I hope you continue doing stand-up, for Christ's sake.
I'm going to. Balls to the wall.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I also have balls, massive ones.
Yeah.
I think you do. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You've got bigger balls than many men.
Oh, by the way, here we go, folks.
No.
Yes, my favorite part of the fuck. I don't give a tiddly fuck. My favorite part of the show. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen. And that's why we're not laughing with Hannah Andrews.
Come on, Hannah.
Woo! Okay, I think you might agree with me that women are very competitive, but like I'm telling you, mothers, they are super competitive, and that happens if postnatal ward. You know, I just given birth and I'm shattered, but that there's so many women and they say, oh, my baby has 33 centimeters circumference of the head. My baby's got 36. My baby's got 38. I'm just looking at them and thinking, oh, my God, do you know what that big head done to your vagina? Do you know the consequences? It's never gonna be back again in the same form of shape as it was before. So I'm just like,
yay.
And shocked.
There we go.
Yes.
Hannah Andrews. And that's why we're not laughing. I think that was your most successful one,
that
Hannah.
That was very true. The ward.
Hannah,
the
after five,
baby ward.
Five attempts, dying on your arse.
I think I semi-died this time.
Yeah, but
well,
we love it. When you, yes. That was really good,
I thought it was good. And it did remind me of being in the rotunda. Because the first baby, I wasn't private. And then I think my dad had some health insurance, so I was private for the second one. The first, the ward with the, like, the non-private, that shit's lit. Like, I remember one girl was like, oh, do you mind? I'm just going to pop out for a cigarette. You just mind the baby. She'd had the baby about 10 minutes ago. I was like, that's a girl boss. Yeah. Go out, have your cigarette. And then she was like, this is how you lose the weight. You just sleep on your front. I was like, really? Second baby, I brought two pairs of Spanx.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh.
And I lost the weight with 24 hours.
There was some wild story that you were telling on Instagram. Mm. What was that story?
Oh, my daughter's dad had sex with a woman and then she got pregnant and she went. We were like quite on Instagram at the time. People would have known us and been talking about us. So then she made this kind of profile being like, I'm pregnant, single mom. This guy is the baby's kid. He doesn't...
Baby's father.
Yeah, he isn't going to make any effort. Blasting him, making this like name for herself off this kind of single motherhood. And I was like to my ex, like we had to have the most awkward conversations. Like, did you ejaculate in this girl? She said she couldn't have kids. Now she's pregnant. She was from somewhere in the country. I was like, because I have my weekends. He takes my daughter every weekend, so I party. And he was like, I'm going to have to... like every second weekend go down to this county and mind this kid. I was like, for fuck's sake, like, no. What? So now I can only party every second. Like, that's not what the hell is going on.
That's not what you wanted.
No.
Or right.
And then turned out that it was just not his baby.
But she had a baby.
She had a baby and for two years.
Two fucking years.
Maybe a year.
How did she find out?
Everyone's like, it's the image of them.
They find out it wasn't?
They did a DNA test. He had to do it on FaceTime.
Oh, right.
Like, because she didn't believe that he put the swab.
And
in
was it such a weight off his shoulders or not? Or was it a shock in terms of he thought he had a kid and now he doesn't have a kid?
I don't really know. We don't really talk about that kind of crap. He doesn't write back when I get... We only talk about the kids.
You got one kid with him?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So,
but you have two, yeah? Mm-hmm.
But sorry, I know you've condensed that story down into... But it was...
It's on my Instagram somewhere.
It was... To me, it was fucking like listening to modern day Shakespeare.
I mean, was wild.
The drama of the whole thing. Mm-hmm. He does do this and she does and she protests and da da da. And then
she took my baby name. That was what pissed me off.
What?
So when she gave birth, I went live on Instagram.
So she like...
What do you mean she took your baby?
She was pretending she was you, basically.
Yeah, do you think she had like a... She was a fan of you and she was like... She wanted your life.
A little bit. She was.
She just taking over.
She took your... What do you mean she took
your... You know, I think she actually probably found out who your... baby's father is.
Oh yeah, and that happened a good few times.
She took your baby name. What does that mean?
So when I was pregnant with Luna, we didn't know if we were gonna have a girl or a boy. So I was like, a boy, Sonny, a girl, Oh, Luna Jade. I see.
Yeah, yeah.
And then she had her kid called Sonia.
Why Luna?
Luna Jade. I kind of wanted like a Jacqueline Wilson novel name.
Can we talk about medication?
Oh yeah. I can't believe you're not on it. Well, I can, but like, why aren't you? Just get on the shit.
For what reason?
Like, it just calms.
I don't need that. No, I need my ups and downs.
I don't know. I thought that for I was afraid if I went on medication, I wouldn't be funny anymore.
What type of medication are you on?
I was on sertraline.
What is that for?
I mean, I just went into the doctors and was like, I'm thinking about unaliving myself. You know, the usual shite. And then they'll give you whatever the fuck you want. No, they only gave me Xanax.
Unaliving is in the same category as ghosting and...
No, counseling. Unaliving is a TikTok word because on TikTok you're not allowed to say killing yourself. Right, so right. They've used other words. Like, you can't say sex, so they say segs.
Oh, segs. Okay. Have you had segs with another woman's... So you try that and then you're on a different one now.
Yes, Lexapro, shit.
What's Lexapro?
I don't really know.
Do you know what Lexapro is for?
No, I don't. Just write it I think it's down. All the same. Maybe it's good for you.
Yeah, check out what it is. I don't know. A friend of mine recommended it. She was like, you know, she's a very anxious kind of person too. And she was like, she went on this and has been on it every single day the same time. I have a little alarm on my phone.
What do you find it does for you?
I just would have like ups and downs and it just levels me out that I'm like pretty much happy all the time where I would have like spurts of like being really like working a lot, like being really funny, making loads of jokes, having a great time, going and using all of that energy. And then I'd like go down and just want to stay in bed, not see anyone. Mm. Like, so it just keeps me, I'm maintaining the best of me.
Okay.
And I love
it. It works by helping to restore the balance of a certain natural substance, serotonin.
Okay, yeah. So if it works for you, fair fucks.
Oh, I love it. Oh, great. Now, apparently some women say that they can't orgasm on it, but my vibrator's broken and I still can.
You have no problem with orgasming?
Yeah, but also like I'd prefer this balance. I'd happily not ever orgasm again for this.
Oh, you can fake it?
No problem. I usually do.
I know. Always men are thinking that, oh, women, I made a cum or something. Women faking it most of the time.
99% of the time.
Yeah, because our hands can't move as fast as a vibrator.
I know. I've gotten used to the vibrator now. I think the aliens are going to come down and they're going to have the vibrator dicks and I'm going to have an alien boyfriend. I can't wait.
We are vibrator people. Hello. Like, how are you doing?
I think I'm going to fancy aliens.
I am an alien. Let me show you my 00.
Because it goes different. There's different, usually speeds. On the vibrators, it's like 100.
Oh, you go from zero. You go
different speed and different.
You can go on tour mode and then turbo mode. Tour mode is. And turbo mode is. It's okay, Jack. Nicolas Cage news.
C-D-E-F-G.
News about Nicolas Cage, the actor.
Do people want to know about Nicolas Cage?
Yeah, fucking Daniel. Yeah. I can't
believe you. Tell me what's going on with him.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay.
Jesus.
I'll let you know. Okay. Yeah. So it looks like Nicolas Cage is going to be back in the MCU, Marvel Cinematic Universe, as Ghost Rider.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah.
I loved Ghost Rider. It was so silly. So basically, he does this deal with the devil whereby he becomes this Ghost Rider and he just sorts out the problems of all the bad stuff perpetrated against people. That's why I loved in particular Riddick. I love that because I've been fighting against power all my life, man.
Have you seen Barbie?
I saw a little bit of Barbie, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Well, I think Ryan Tuberty is very similar to Barbie. Like he grew up in Barbie Land, RTE, very cosseted, and then he got ejected, and suddenly he's in this world where people aren't being nice to him. But that's good because he needs that to make him, okay. He needs a bit of controversy.
What do you predict for him now?
Oh, he'll start his own podcast, I assume, and he'll.
Do you think people would listen?
Oh yeah, well, like,
does he have diehard fans?
I think so.
Oh.
I mean, do you think people? You know, of course, people would listen. I mean,
well, like he's
got 200 followers, 200,000.
Does he?
I would certainly. I mean, he's been on the front pages for the past month.
I know, but I couldn't give a fuck.
I know, because you're not his audience. I'm not his audience.
I know, but then his audience would, they'd be like, how do I be getting onto the podcasts? They wouldn't know.
Yeah, that's right.
Like, how do I listen to that now? Get that up for me now.
Game of Thrones. This Game of Thrones are right in Tubber Day.
But it's the same. You see, like, Adrian Kennedy and Jeremy Dixon, they're on the podcast. They still haven't got to the where they were when they were in their heyday.
Adrian Kennedy, is that the guy who talks like that?
Yeah, that yeah. was that show. I'm a pirate. Made me.
Yeah, come on. Yeah, marry. Marry.
Yeah, no, I don't.
Yeah, why not?
Because.
Yeah, all right. Or something.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, go ahead. What is that? Adrian Kennedy.
Adrian Kennedy and Jeremy's.
Is he the guy with the wig?
No, I don't think he has a wig. Do you know who I fucking never liked, and I'm delighted he was. He got well. He can't. You can't get cancelled, but you can cancel yourself. Owen McDermott. He cancelled himself. Remember all that shit came out on Twitter that he was apparently, just doing stuff with a 17-year-old, sending her Victoria's Secret lingerie and stuff.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Wiped from RTE. RTE said yeah. nothing.
Okay. Thank you. Thanks lovely, for having me. Concise thing.
With, don't be with, patronizing.
I am patronizing. I'm patronizing.
Okay.
Don't fuck with
oh.
me.
Oh. What would happen if she did? Because I'm sure she has.
Oh look, you're so full of yourself because you did well. thank you for the concise Nicolas Cage fucking thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sounds better.
I can't do right for doing wrong. Do you yes. hear people who say good. That? Can I just talk about that? Okay. Okay, Jack Conspiracy Corner.
Today on Conspiracy Corner, we're talking about some developments in Russia. They are floating to plan to build a village for conservative Americans who want to move to a Christian country and are tired of liberal ideology in the United States. And when they go over there, they'll be offered acres, animals, and an Orthodox Christian spouse to choose from.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Oh, right. So it's like, yeah, Jesus Christ.
So Russian girls still want them.
Well, you know, it's a mix of, you know, just... you know, there's a market for it, you know, to
can you imagine
move
some
to
big,
another place.
Gross American incel who just see, you know, yeah, I've got saved up a lot of money and going out with your Moscow. And so, God almighty, it's so embarrassing. Guys, like you know, you're 57, mate. You know what I mean? Just grow okay. up. Jack, sorry, all that will be cut out. Yeah, what do you think about that? You know, it sounds like a brave new world. It sounds like a little cult or, you know, setting up for rich
Well, it's funny because people went to America for the land of opportunity and now they're coming back, you know?
Yeah.
Very
for
true.
The other opportunity.
Although know? When I was in Ukraine, I must say the women there were incredibly very attractive.
I would say, yeah.
Yeah.
And I guess they're not as... you know, they have a more conservative outlook on life.
Well, I would just say to those Americans who are considering going over to Russia and, you know, planting themselves, Cavan, very conservative place, yeah, Tipperary, yeah. And the women there have great values, and they, you know, they
and
meet,
those areas need to be populated.
Those areas need to be populated.
You know?
So please, Americans, forget about Russia. There's still large areas
Go back
of
to
Ireland
your roots.
That are, you know, very Catholic, very conservative. Mm-hmm. And, you know, a good, sturdy, comely maiden.
And their ancestors probably lived there before, so you're just going back to where you're from, you know?
True.
Genuinely, Lindsay, I'd love to sit... We've been talking for ages, and I'd love to talk to you for longer. We're going to go to Crackden.
Yes.
And thank you so much for coming
Thanks
here.
For having
it was so
me, guys.
Nice to talk to you. Thank you, Hannah. Thank you, my
you
princes, Jack
me.
And Daniel. Yeah, let's go. Let's thank you, everyone. See you next week. Do you know this?
Yeah.